welcome the machine of love. Yes, it's Ray Foley!
Welcome to Take Me Out. We've come to the final show of the series. Give me an aww.
Aww.
To bring on the girls! Here we are in the final show of the series. I love you all so much. It's going to be so hard to let go. Let's have a chat with a few of our ladies and see how they're getting on tonight. Orla.
Oh, Ray, if I don't see shifters tonight, I'm going to be very depressed.
You're going to be stood outside on your own.
I'll find someone to take me home tonight.
Oh! All right, looking for the audience.
What do you mean?
I've been here since week one.
I know. Do you think, is it you or is it them?
Well, I've left my light on a couple of times. I think it's their fault.
Yeah.
For turning me off.
I
Please
know.
Go to Specsavers.
They're mad, aren't they? Lorraine.
Ray, what can I say? I've been here since week one as well. At the start, I went for tall, dark and handsome. Dropped it down to personality. And now at this stage, I'm in heels for 10 weeks. I just want somebody who can massage my feet at this stage.
Hi, Foley.
Hey, Niamh.
Hey.
What are you doing here?
I don't know. I'm too fussy.
You're wasting my time, I swear to God. You're here
You're
how many weeks now?
You're wasting my time.
You're wasting my... I'm bringing out the finest, the cream of the Irish crop. They're all stood there in that circle in front of you and you go, no, no, no.
It's because they're nothing like you, Foley. I need to, like, drop me standards
now. Clearly, your standards are way too high. You need to sort that out before you go any further. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for our girls! Each girl has a light on in front of them. When our boy comes through that door, he'll have three chances to impress. And if my girls like what they see, they'll keep their lights turned on. If they don't like what they see, they'll turn their lights off. For example, if I was to say, I'd probably pass judgment on you, whatever you do. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I've the most punchable, smug, annoying face. I'm Piers Morgan. And it's a total blackout, and our man goes home alone. Okay, girls, lights on. And girls, now it's time to play for real. Are you ready for your first man? Ah, girls, come on. It's the last show. Are you ready for your first man? That's more like it. If you're ready, I'm ready. It's girls, time to bring on the boy. Welcome to the show, sir. They are all yours. Take it away.
Hey, girls, I'm Rob and I'm from Mayo.
Girls, that's Rob from Mayo. Girls, are you turned on or turned off? Oh! Four girls gone, 26 remaining. That is a result, Rob. How are you feeling?
I'm pretty happy with that now.
Good stuff. Stay right there. Let me have a chat with some of the ladies who turned off their lights. Lol, you left your light on. Things are looking good over here.
Oh, Razor, things are looking very good. Look at that T-shirt.
Oh, Rob, you lucky duck. Mm. You've got 26 girls still interested in you. That is a great result at the end of our first round, and you're still in the game. But how will they feel once they take a look at this? Remember, girls, if you're feeling nothing, push that button.
I started playing Gaelic when I was 7. It was tough at the start, like, I wasn't that big, but it was grand. I played on field then, but I started playing in Goa and started going better. Then I won a minor Connacht medal with Mayo, got to the All-Ireland final that year as well. Another love I have is music and musicals as well, I must say, like Glee and Moulin Rouge. I think they're class. I just love them kind of things.
Don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling.
I would love to be in Glee. I'd love to be like the Finn character. That's my favourite character. I think he's brilliant. Like.
Rob, I have to ask, did you not realise there was a camera crew in your living room at the time? No? Third round, and one more chance to impress our ladies. You got a little tune for them?
Have.
Feeling good?
Yeah.
Nervous?
Not too bad.
I'd be nervous too if I was stood in front of them and have to sing what you're going to sing next. Yeah. Ladies, though, if you're feeling the passion, keep that light flashing.
And I can't fight this feeling anymore. I've forgotten what I started fighting for. It's time to bring this ship into the shore. So hang on. Maybe I can't fight this feeling anymore.
That was great. That's from Glee as well, is it?
It is from Glee, yeah. He sings in the shower. Brilliant.
All right, OK. Man, you know the scenes and everything.
I don't know what to
do. All right, well, that's two girls in that round. 18 still on, which means, Rob, you've definitely got a date tonight! This is my favourite bit, because now the power. Now the power is in your hands. 16 lights have to go off out there, Rob. Away you go. I do not envy you. Audience, who should he go for? Get rid of them. Leave two standing. Janine and Lou. Come on, Rob, make a decision. Janine's gone. One more light. Lou is still in the game between Niamh and Lauren. Who's he going to take out tonight? Oh, give a round of applause. Bro. Rob, it's your turn to find out something about our two remaining girls. That's Lou and Niamh. Two beautiful women. I do not envy your final decision. You have to ask them one question to find out a little bit more about them, and depending on their answers, you decide on who you're taking out tonight. Rob, if you're ready, ask away. Good luck, sir.
All right, girls. As you've seen, I'm a Gleek. I wonder if you've got any guilty pleasures, and if so, what are they?
Oh, OK, guilty pleasures. Niamh, your guilty pleasure, missus.
Well, for the past few weeks, I've been always torn off my light, and tonight you are definitely my guilty pleasure.
Ah! Lou!
Well, my guilty pleasure is a little bottle of wine in the evening, mm-hmm. but I don't really feel that guilty about it, and I'd love someone to share it with.
Ah! Okay. Flattery or drinkery? That's your choice, Rob. One of our girls, I need to tell you that one of our girls once mooned a taxi. I'm looking at both of them and trying to work out which one it is. One of our girls once mooned a taxi. I think I have a fair idea as well.
Yeah.
Armed with that information, get out there and turn one light off and take one out. Who should he go for, audience? Give him a hand. Is he going to take out Niamh or Lou? Niamh or Lou? Is it Niamh or is it Lou? You're fine, you're fine, you're grand.
Listen, I want you to treat her right, okay? She's my special girl. Look after her, all right? Show her a good time, okay? Before we go any further, you're happy, first of all, yeah?
Oh, very happy, yeah.
You're happy, yeah? Yeah? You're happy?
Yeah.
Good stuff. I should let you know that the girl who stuck her arse out the back of the window and mooned the taxi, Rob, who do you think it was?
I couldn't think it was an Eve, right?
It was Niamh. And lads, your date tonight will put you in mind of the beautiful city of Venice. That's right, the toilets are flooded once again in Shifter!
Jesus Christ, I was so
nerve-wracking.
Flipping hell.
I had to pick Niamh. As soon as I came onto stage, I saw her, like, and I was like, geez, she's nice. Like, so I was like, I kind of had my eye on her, but so I kind of went with my gut instinct from the start.
I left my eye on because I thought he was a really nice fella, and I'm really glad I did, even though I didn't dig his tiger top at the start, but we'll see what happens.
Delighted. Last time on Take Me Out, Sean went on a date with Lorna, but did they hit it off? Let's find out.
My first impressions of Sean, though, were quite good.
My first impression was she was absolutely gorgeous and she was totally my type.
Sean complimented me on the date a couple of times.
Well, I don't mean that. I have to say, yeah. You're gorgeous, though.
Thank you.
No problem.
I think we really hit it off. She's a technician and I come from an electrical background, so maybe sparked my fly in the end.
When I came on the show, Ray asked me what I was looking for in a man. I told him I needed big shoulders, nicer around, and definitely personality. And Sean ticked all the boxes.
That seemed to go well. Okay, those presents aren't gonna wrap themselves, so we'll be back right after these. We saw Rob take Niamh out. That means we've got room for a new girl. Everyone say hello to Donna! Hey, Donna.
Hey, Foley.
Welcome to the show, Mrs. Our final episode. Are we going to find you a date tonight?
Hopefully.
Hopefully. Fingers crossed. What are you looking for in a man, Donna?
Cute. Badass.
Cute badass?
But...
Does that mean his arse doesn't have to be attractive?
No, it does.
What? Oh, it has to be an attractive arse, but he needs to be a bad, he needs to be a mean guy, is that it?
But no, he can't be a player.
Oh, okay, right. Cute, badass, not a player. Uh-huh. Okay, fair enough. Everyone, I'll see what I can do for you, Donna. But everyone, give it up for Donna! I'll find you a guy. Time is getting tight, though, Donna. Well, I'll do my best. Right, I think it's time for our next man. Girls, shall we? Alright then, open that box and bring on the boy! I'm delighted. Last time on Take Me Out, Michael hooked up with Mairead. So, let's see how they got on.
Yeah. How are you? Yeah.
When I first saw Mairead, I was really happy with my choice. She's a lovely looking girl and she seemed to have a lovely personality and was really looking forward to the day ahead.
It went really well, actually.
We'll have a toast.
To good choices.
I thought it might be a bit awkward and we'd have nothing to talk about, but the conversation just flowed and flowed. We talked about work and pets and school even, and it was actually probably the best first date I've ever been on.
After the date, I was still happy with my choice. We were still having the crack and the banter as we left Shifters. I'd actually love to see Mairead again. So we'll see how it pans out.
Not my standard type, to be honest, but he's a fine bit of stuff and I'd be willing to change my type for him. I'd love to see him again.
Wasn't that lovely? All right, then, those stockings aren't going to fill themselves, so we'll be back after these. Welcome back. Last time, we matched up Dave and Aoife. Let's have a peep and see how they got on.
Good, how are you?
Cheers.
Oh, when I first met Aoife, I was very impressed with her. She's a good looking girl.
I thought that he was great. He was nice and tall, and I meet a tall guy, and he seemed like he's good crack. He said he wouldn't shut up like when he's talking, so, and he certainly didn't shut up, so it was grand.
Aoife would be the normal type of girl to go for. She's tall, good looking, she's a good figure, and she's a good sense of humour, so.
He's just good crack, like he. It's not going to be awkward because he talks as much as I talk.
Yes, I am glad I picked Aoife. I think it was a good choice. And I wouldn't have stopped her for anyone else, you know?
I thought you were going to take my life. I was like, no!
No!
After getting to know Dave and getting to know him a bit better, I think I would definitely be attracted to him.
That went all right. OK, today I've already matched up Donal and Nuala. That means we've a new girl. Say hello, everyone, to Aoife. Pronounce that right. Is it Aoife or Eve?
It's Aoife, don't get that wrong.
All right, Christmas Aoife.
We'll let you have that one.
For the time of year, it's fine. Okay, what are you looking for?
A man. I'm sick of boys.
Oh, okay.
Simple as.
A man, that's all, just
that's,
a man.
That's it, just a man.
Okay, fine, I'll see what I can do for you.
Thank
I'm sure
you.
I can rustle one of those up in the next few minutes. Yes. Give it up for Aoife, everybody. All right, it's time to meet our next man. Are you ready, girls? Raise the drawbridge and bring on the boy! Welcome to the show, sir. They are all yours. Take it away.
How's it going, girls? I'm Derek and I'm from Donegal.
Hey! Derek from Donegal and girls, are you turned on or turned off? All right. That's not too bad. That's okay. That's good. That's good. Still a lot of light still on there in front of us. 17 gone, but 13 still remaining. Let's see why some of our ladies turned off their lights. Let's head down this way for sophisticated Samantha.
It's the shoes.
What?
The shoes.
The shoes. The shoes. What's wrong with the shoes?
They're like Christmas stockings.
Yeah.
They use.
It's Christmas.
Christina, you left your light on as well. What do you see that you like?
I did indeed. What was the point in turning out my light when I don't know nothing about this chap? Could be a millionaire or anything.
Derek, you're still in the game, but these girls would like to know a little bit more about you. You've got one more round. You've got 30 seconds to impress them. And girls, if you're feeling nothing, push that button.
Hi, dear girls. You all look beautiful tonight. I'm a big music fan, but not a music snob. I like everything from Johnny Cash to Snoop Dogg, more or less everything. Like me fashion. I just might look a wee bit. Sorry if you don't like the hoodie. But, yeah, so if you need someone to shop to your drop, I'm your man.
All right, Derek, you've got four girls left. Four ladies still to impress as we head into our third and final round. You have to impress to leave with a date, and girls, if it doesn't feel right, then kill that light.
Okay, a woman name across the chest. Leave your lights on, you don't need the rest. I'm a hustler, baby, yeah. I'll sell fire to hell, water to hell. Good one on me, BJZ. Good one,
Derek. What happened? Let's go out there.
I don't know.
Well, I'll find out. Don't worry, sir. Let's see what went on there. A total blackout. Lauren, you turned your light off there and tell us why.
I know, you look like someone that plays the drums, and I thought it was going to be a drum kit come out, and I was going to be like, yeah, definitely.
I do play the drums. I play guitar, drums, piano, I play whatever you want, just to hear you.
Had we only known. No, that was his party piece, he wanted to do a bit of rapping for you.
I'm so sorry, if you had drum kits, I would have said.
Oh, come to my house later, sure, I'll play some drums for you.
Derek, maybe you should have left the wrapping for the presents.
Yeah.
But come here, big guy, I'll give you a little cuddle.
Oh, there you go.
Happy Christmas. Give it up, everybody, for Derek. Away you go.
A lot of them didn't like my shoes, but yeah, what can you do? And also, the rapping wasn't top class now, I'll say that myself.
Poor Derek. Last time on Take Me Out, Paul went on a date with Sarah Jane. Now, let's have a look and see how they got on.
How are you?
Good.
Good,
not too bad.
When I met Paul first on my first date, I thought he was a really nice guy, really good looking, and we definitely have a lot of common.
There was definitely a lot of flirting going on. I think she's really into me, so I can't really blame her.
Okay.
So do you drive?
Of course I do, yeah.
Because you're driving me crazy.
I would definitely say I'm attracted to Paul. His personality definitely shines, and he's got really great eyes.
I'm not looking for a relationship at the moment. I'm not really a relationship guy.
I would see Paul again. Yeah, I would definitely go on another date with Paul and see how it goes.
I don't know if I'll see her again. We'll have to see. Again, play it by ear. She's from Waterford, so it's not too far from Cork. And she seems to know her way around Cork pretty well, so she might call over sometime. I don't know.
I think that went well enough. OK, folks, those bells aren't going to jingle themselves. We'll be right back after these. Welcome back. In the last round, we had a blackout. So, we still have 30 girls, and it's time to meet our next man. Ladies, are you ready? All right, I'll take that as a yes. Unwrap that chap and bring on the boy! Love kick starts again. Welcome to the show, sir. They are all yours. Knock 'em dead.
Ladies, hello. How are you all doing? My name is Dermot Cahill. I'm from Clochjordan in Tipperary.
That's Dermot from Tip. But girls, are you turned on or turned off? Is that it? Wow. Amy C. Amy, quick fire over there. One girl gone and 20 line lights still on. That is brilliant, Dermot.
That's not too bad, mate.
Don't get too full of yourself now. Let's get out there and have a chat with Amy, who turned off her light. Although, I think it came as something as a surprise to you as well, Amy.
Sure, I wasn't looking around, but I'm so embarrassed that I'm the only one who turned off the light. I look like a right beep. I can't. It was just because I saw that your T-shirt tucked into your jeans.
It is.
I'm really sorry. I have a weird thing about things being tucked, like shorts being tucked in and stuff. It just reminds me of...
Let's get it out. Come on. Whip it out. Come on.
You could have tucked it out later. I'm sorry. Only one. Cringe
okay.
On me.
Okay, there's clearly something wrong with Amy. There's nothing we can do about that. Give it up for our girls. All right. Nice one. Jamie, you are our last guy of the entire series. How do you feel about that?
Hopefully I'll be lucky.
You will be lucky by the looks of things. 29 lights still on. Let's see what our girls think of this. And girls, step away from those buzzers and take a look at this. Best of luck, my friend, and away you go.
Here come the girls.
results are 3 girls gone in that round, with 26 remaining. Nice fancy finger work there as well. Well done. All right, let's go and have a chat with some of our ladies who turned their lights off. Minerva, why'd you turn off your light?
Working every weekend. And then DJs, they love lots of attention from the ladies with the special requests they send in after every session. So no. Not happening.
No, no. Minerva, you realise I'm a DJ?
Yeah. Exactly.
Ali, your light is still on as well.
Yeah. Great song choices. Really personalised it for the show. Great idea. Good way of keeping in. And I wouldn't mind kissing you under the mistletoe tonight.
Nice one. Jermaine is our final single boy of the series, with 26 girls still interested in him. You're not going to let that go to your head now, are you?
Not at all.
No, okay. Very modest. Good guy. Dermot, you have one more chance to impress our ladies. You've got 30 seconds to do that. It's time. You got flirty for 30. Take it away, Dermot. And ladies, is he the one that you want or the one that you won't?
Okay, ladies. First of all, I'm not a bi racer. I'm into my cars, my Volkswagen cars. I first started driving a Volkswagen Vento, moved on to a Mark IV Golf, moved on to 2 Mark Vs, and now I'm driving a Volkswagen Touareg GT. It is my pride and joy. I do like it. If we go out on a night together and you have a few drinks, I end up driving home, just try and not get sick in the car.
12 girls gone, 14 remaining. I guess very chivalrous of you that you'd drive them home. With 14 girls remaining, that means you have a daze! Now, the power is in your hands. You have to whittle it down to just 2 girls. With all these lights on in front of you, leave on the 2 lights you'd most like to see in the final round. Get out there and leave 2 lights on. Who should he go for, audience? Give him a hand. Tracy, Aisling, Samantha's still in the game, Carla, who else? Adele, Janine, Lou. Dermot, you have to turn them off, not walk past them, dude. We've got Janine, Adele, you need to turn off 4 more lights for me, please. Adele, Janine is still there, Carla's still in the game. Oh no, Carla's gone, Samantha's gone. Donna, one more, there we go. Well done, my friend. Janine and Tracy still in the game. They know a lot about you, Dermot, but you know damn all about them. This is your chance to find out a little bit more. One question for both of our ladies. Fire away, my friend. Best of luck.
Okay, ladies. I was attacked by a dog when I was younger by an Alsatian and lucky to be alive. If we were out for a walk in a park and a dog came up running and growling at me, what can you do for me?
Tracy, what would you do about that?
I love dogs, I have to admit. I do love dogs and all I can say is I'd get rid of the beast and make sure you get plenty of TLC.
Ah. Okay, and Janine?
Well, I'm actually a former European karate champion. So if you went out with me, there'd be no dogs attacking you. I'll be able to protect you.
Ah, nice one. So, Dermot, it's between TLC and Taekwondo. You have a tough choice ahead of you between our 2 ladies. And I have to tell you, before you make that choice, one of our girls can put her leg behind her head. One of our girls can put her leg behind her head. Our final single man of the series, get out there and turn one off and take one out. Audience, give him a hand. Who should he go for, everybody? Janine or Tracy? Who's he going to turn off? Is Janine still in the game? What? Is he going to turn? Come on.
Come on.
Is he going to turn Tracy off? Oh, yes! Janine has a date, I can't believe it! Missus, you've got to be happy at the end of that round.
Yeah, told you, saving the best for last.
Exactly, finally Janine has a date at the very end of the series and we're delighted. Are you happy?
I'm happy.
Good stuff. I have to let you know before we go any further that Janine is the girl who can put her leg behind her head. Don't worry, Janine, we won't ask you to show us. We're sending you guys on your date, and where we're sending you will put you in mind of the fantasy world of Hogwarts. It's only a Quidditch, a Quidditch in at Shifter!
Oh, I had to leave my light on, he was perfect. And as I'm saying, he was the best, and I was the best, and we were both left to last.
Janine just looked like great crack. She seems to be a really solid girl. I just can't wait to go on a date with her.
That's what I call a great end result. Okay, folks, we've had an emotional 10 weeks. We've had lots of highs and lows, plenty of laughter and tears, and countless gin tonics. And I've managed to send loads of couples to Shifters, the hottest spot in a 40-metre radius. Tonight alone, we had 3 brand-new matches. Let's check out how tonight's couples got on, starting with Rob, who wooed Niamh with his love of Glee. Take a look.
About time, Rashada.
Yeah,
literally. How are you? I have to say, my first impression of Rob was probably his tiger top, and I didn't really like it. But then when I got to know him, he seemed really, really sweet, and how he played, he was really played the gaff up while he was really athletic, so I was like, yeah.
We have a good bit in common, like, she wants to do the same things as me. Like, she's doing TV presenting and I'm doing communication, so it's similar. Like, so I'd love to be in the presenting. Like, I'd love Dermot O'Leary.
Oh my God, yeah. I want to be Holly Willoughby. So the two of us can do the X-Facts together. Yeah, because I'm a bit of a flirty girl. I wouldn't mind a flirt here and there, but he was real like, what's your name, what's your age, what do you want to do when you're older? Do you like shopping? It's like, yeah, I want to go out and have fun. You going to join me?
Niamh definitely would be the kind of girl I go for in a nightclub. You know, she's pretty and she's striking looking, so that's good.
If he asks me out on a date again, I don't know, I'll just have to see what happens, but could be, yeah.
And we all and Janine went to Shifters too. Let's have a look and see how they got on.
My first impressions of Dermot was he was really good looking and I knew he'd be great crack, so that's why I was glad he picked me.
Janine was just smashing looking girls. She ticked all the right boxes tonight, and so I was delighted I got to pick her.
The date went really well. He told me at the start of the date that he didn't drink. You don't drink at all?
No interest in it.
Oh, you never told me that. But it didn't seem to be a problem at the end of the day, because as the day went on, he didn't need a drink to loosen up. He was having the crack and it was good.
I hope there's a spark between us. It'd be nice if something came out of it.
I'm not sure whether there was much chemistry on the date, but he's a lovely guy and I wouldn't mind meeting up with him again, but maybe just as friends.
Definitely wouldn't mind seeing Janine again, and I am going to ask her for her number and we'll see how things go.
Well, it's been real. I didn't find dates for all my ladies, but I'm just looking at the small print in my contract and, yeah, it says that if they don't get dates, they all get to go out with me! Take me out! Come on, ladies!
Before I have to go by the first round in Shifters, I'd like to wish everyone watching and our boys and girls a happy Christmas. We'll be back in January to find love for 30 more single girls in a brand new series of Take Me Out. Have a good one.